We were all saddened to learn of the untimely passing of our friend and colleague, the gentleman from the 133rd Legislative District, Representative Dan McNeill. As is our custom, we will now take a few moments for a memorial service to reflect upon his life and service to the House of Representatives, to the constituents in his district, and to everyone in the Commonwealth at large. At this time, we are now going to consider the condolence resolution for Representative McNeill. Please proceed.
Whereas the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania wishes to honor the memory of the Honorable Daniel McNeill, who served in the 133rd District of the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania with honor and distinction, and passed away on September 8, 2017. And whereas Representative McNeill graduated from Lewis E. Dyruff High School and served in the Pennsylvania National Guard. He was a former business agent, secretary, and treasurer of Iron Workers Local Union No. 36, a past vice president of the Lehigh Valley Building Trades, and past commissioner for Whitehall Township. He further served as Whitehall Township executive and manager of regional partnerships for Lehigh County prior to his 2012 election to the House of Representatives, where he served on the Agriculture and Rural Affairs, Finance, Labor and Industry, Local Government, and Professional Licensure Committees. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the House of Representatives of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania proclaim with enduring sorrow the passing of the Honorable Daniel McNeill and extend heartfelt condolences to his wife of 32 years, Jeannie Moudry McNeill, daughters Kathleen, Shannon, and Heather, granddaughter Mackenzie, and be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution, sponsored by Representatives Mike Terzai, Dave Reed, Frank Dermody, Brian Cutler, Michael K. Hanna Sr., Ryan A. Bizarro, Marty Flynn, Robert L. Freeman, Ed Nielsen, Steve Samuelson, Mike Schlossberg, and Peter Schweier on September 18, 2017, be transmitted to Jeannie Moudry McNeill.
Thank you. Those in favor of the adoption of the resolution will rise as a mark of respect for our former colleague. Guests, please also rise as able. Members and guests, please take your seats. The resolution has been unanimously adopted. Members, I'm going to just say a few remarks and then I'll conclude at the end. The majority leader will have an opportunity to speak. The minority leader will have an opportunity to speak. I would also indicate that any member who wishes to speak will be given the opportunity to do so. Certainly, we always honor those former members that have passed away, but this is a sitting member. This was one of our present-day colleagues and friends. If any member wishes to speak, you are more than welcome to do so. I will, of course, first call the majority leader, the minority leader, and then any other guests that wish to say some words. We will follow that with a presentation of citation and memorial flag to Representative McNeill's wife and daughters. And we'll have a closing prayer by Representative Brian Barvin. On behalf of the House of Representatives, I wish to convey our deepest sympathy to Representative Dan McNeill's wife of 32 years, Jean, and their daughters, Kathleen, Shannon, Heather, and granddaughter Mackenzie. I apologize, but I am going to ask his wife Jeannie and the daughters to please stand at this time so that we can express our sadness to you personally, and granddaughter Mackenzie. Representative McNeill will sorely be missed by you, his loving family, and his great friends, and his constituents, and all of his colleagues here in the House of Representatives. I must tell you, I was honored to be at the service, and it was so loving, and the stories that were conveyed by the young man who spoke at the service and the Reverend, I think touched all of us, really. It just touched all of us. Dan truly left his mark on this august institution and on the wide array of people whose lives he touched back in the district and throughout the Commonwealth. At this time, I would like to ask the Majority Leader to set forth his remarks, followed by the Minority Leader, and then if anybody else wishes to speak, please let me know. Representative Reed, the Majority Leader.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. It's a very sad day that we mourn the passing but celebrate the life of Representative McNeill. Now, Dan and I did not share geographic proximity. We were not on the same side of the political aisle, and I am not of the same generation that Dan came from. Dan and I rarely talked about public policy, but we had the opportunity almost every day to share a conversation. I would see Dan almost every morning in the gym, which may seem like an odd place for a 39-year-old and a 70-year-old to gather on a daily basis. And our attire was a little bit different because I was normally in gym shorts and a t-shirt, and Dan was always in a suit and tie every single morning. It became obvious from the very beginning that Dan had not come down to work out, but Dan came down for the conversation. He was an early riser. He liked to get to know people at a personal level. He liked to share family experiences, life experiences, and wanted to get away from the partisan bickering that sometimes dominates the discussion on the House floor. So we got to know a little bit about each other. We got to know about each other's family, and I just enjoyed Dan's company. He was easy to talk to. You know, he's a hard worker, a dedicated family man, and more than anything else, he truly cared about the people he represented, not just of his district, but across the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. He was just a good person trying to do the right thing for the right reasons each and every day. Dan and I also would pass on the House floor almost every day at the end of the session. He would walk past this podium, and generally, you know, depending on how the day went, he would always kind of elbow me on the way through and say, "Hey, if you need me to take care of any of these knuckleheads, you just let me know. I'm more than willing to help out." It's just the kind of guy he was. You know, just a little bit of humor mixed with humility, mixed with just a good-natured view on life. Dan and I have known each other for a number of years, but I can honestly say we never once talked about the health problems he was suffering through. He dealt with them himself and was always worried about your problems more than his. When I heard of Dan's passing, I was shocked, number one, that he was 70 years old. I didn't think he was that old. And number two, I just couldn't imagine going to the gym in the morning and not seeing my friend. So today, as we mourn his loss, but we celebrate his life, to his daughters, Kathleen, Shannon, Heather, his granddaughter, Mackenzie, and his wife, Jeannie, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for sharing your loved one with us. He made a difference in my life, and our lives, and the lives of each and every Pennsylvanian. Thank you for having him be part of the history of this chamber and this Commonwealth. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Leader Reed. And the Minority Leader, Representative Frank Dermody.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To Dan's wife, Jeannie, and his daughters, Kathleen, Shannon, and Heather, and his granddaughter, Mackenzie, thank you for being with us here today. We're also joined by two of Dan's legislative staff, McDee from the district and Maria from the Capitol, as well as some of Dan's closest friends from home. We all appreciated Dan's warmth and his fighting spirit, And it's great that you're with us today to honor such a dear friend. Dan was proud to be a state legislator, and he was a proud working man, a lifelong iron worker. He was a leader of his union and vice president of the Lehigh Valley Building Trades. Dan cared about finding good jobs for people, and he identified with working people and their struggles all his life. He came from organized labor. That was his story. He later went on to serve in elected and appointed positions in Whitehall Township and Lehigh County governments before winning election in 2012 as state representative of the 133rd District. Anyone who has served with Dan here in Harrisburg will tell you that he never forgot his roots. He never forgot where he came from, not for a minute. That's one of the things we all loved about him. Dan was a genuine guy. When elected to public office, he didn't change who he was because there was no need to. You knew he would tell you the truth as he saw it, most of the time telling you a pleasant story, sometimes not. He'd always tell you the truth whether you wanted to hear it or not. He was a proud Irishman, and he most certainly had the gift for telling a good story. And we did love Dan for his honesty. We knew this was a man who would stand by us, and he would stand up for us. But also one, as I said before, would always tell you the things you might not always want to hear. That happened to me several times. But actually, the good news was there were things that I needed to hear. And he would always tell you the truth. He was a friend through thick and thin and good and bad times. The Lehigh Countyans he represented got to find that out as well. They went to Dan's office often. He was one of the busiest district offices, and he took care of everybody and anybody who walked through the door. He never forgot that he was a public servant, and he did his best to serve the people he represented. He understood that somebody showed up at his office, they were probably at the end of their rope. They had nowhere else to turn. And he made sure that he did what he could to make their day better and to make their lives better. He made his mission to do whatever he could do to help his folks, to help his constituents, no matter where they were from. We saw that here in Harrisburg on his work on the Safe Streets programs, on job training programs and union apprenticeship programs, on crime prevention. And in the last several years, he was a leader in a passionate response to the prescription drug and the heroin crisis we have that's gripping every part of our state. Dan was taken away from us suddenly, and we really all never got a chance to say goodbye. So I hope that you and his family and friends will understand how much he meant to all of us in this house and take some comfort in that, Jeannie. Because Jan and I share an Irish heritage, I'd like to share a line from the great Irish poet William Butler Yeats. He said, "Think where man's glory most begins and ends, and say my glory was I had such friends." Mr. Speaker, our glory was that we had such a friend as Dan McNeill. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Leader Dermody. At this time, if any other members wish to speak, you are more than welcome to do so. We also have a presentation that we're going to be doing. Representative Schlossberg, please, in the front podium.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Let me start by acknowledging a fundamental truth about today's proceedings. It is very, very difficult to memorialize a man whose very presence was so larger than life. Everything about Danny was big. His heart was big. His passion for working men and women was big. His desire to improve the lives of the people he represented was enormous. Danny took an unorthodox route to the House. Now, most of us have a somewhat similar pattern, a career in politics, law, business, or education, maybe holding a local office or two. Danny was a bouncer. He was an iron worker, building casinos in Atlantic City before becoming a business agent. Bitten by the political bug, Danny ran for office, being elected as a Whitehall Township supervisor and then becoming township executive. His service to the people of Whitehall was a hallmark of his career, one that stretched many decades. And when I think of Whitehall, I can't help but think of Danny. His presence is everywhere there, from the bustle of MacArthur Road to the quietest farm on the outskirts of the town. I can think of countless stories about Danny, but an accurate retelling of these stories would require me using more colorful language than the speaker would probably allow. So let me just say this. Danny was loved. and he was really, really well-liked. His friends were from all walks of life, from across the political spectrum. His death broke hearts across the Lehigh Valley, everyone from the head of our local building trades to the president of the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce. If you were a good person, he was with you, and that went for everyone, from our Republican sheriff to Governor Wolf. There were three fundamental truths to Danny. First, every story he told usually came back to a shore house in Brigantine. Second, he was an iron worker, through and through, and he'd never hesitate to tell you. Third, he loved his family more than words can say. Literally, not a day went by without hearing about his wife, companion, and best friend, Jeannie. He adored his daughters, Kathleen, Shannon, and Heather, as well as his godson, Scott. And I know there are many members on the floor who heard about his family countless times. Who we heard most of all about was Kenzie, his four-year-old granddaughter, who loved hanging out with her pop. He was so proud and so thrilled when she was born. And I remember him being right over there on the floor talking about his daughter being in labor and how he couldn't wait. Danny might be the first person I ever knew who was born to be a grandfather. My tenure so far in the House has been brief, and this is only the second time that I've been present when a member of this chamber has left us too soon. I know that Danny's death leaves a hole that cannot be filled. Time moves on, and in a couple of months, the people of the 133rd Legislative District will elect a new representative. But I would hope, and I believe, that all of us are richer for having known Danny, that our lives have a little more color, that our perspectives are a little broader, and that our hearts are a little bit bigger. And I know Danny would have wanted it that way. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Representative Schlossberg. Representative Nielsen?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm going to wait for our compadres to come up because we have a little presentation that we'd like to present in the family. But we had a lot of comments on the way in today saying how well-dressed Marty and Ryan and I are. That's because today we're sporting the McNeill ties, stains and all. Danny wasn't real good at tying a knot. So Jeannie would make sure when he came to Harrisburg that they were tied for him. And please be assured, while they don't look alike, they all three are Danny's knots. And quite frankly, as his friends, we are really honored that Jeannie and the girls actually asked us to have one. And it's something that we'll hold close to our heart for a long time. We hung around a lot with Danny. We did the morning things after we got done with you. He came up to us, and we'd have a lot of coffee, and we'd watch the news. And at night when we went home, because we lived together, and we would share those stories, and we would have to watch some real poor football games. And every time we went to change the channel, because Danny was sleeping and snoring away, he'd say, "Great game, isn't it?" And you're like, "What?" He was sleeping for 2 hours. It's like, but he would know. But the highest quality that we found with Danny is his caring quality and loyalty. Loyalty, something that you don't find in politics. Danny was old school. When Danny shook a hand or gave his word, it was good as gold. Good as gold. You can take it to the bank and cash it in. And he was a great friend to all of us, and he is sorely missed, and he will be missed. As we know, I guess would Mr. Speaker would now be appropriate to do the presentation. Would that?
Yes, I think that would be very appropriate. Representative Nielsen and Representative Bizarro, Representative Flynn have taken the time to actually put together a very, very wonderful gift for the family, for Jeannie and the daughters and granddaughter. You may know that the good representative served in the Pennsylvania National Guard for 6 years, receiving an honorable discharge coming out of high school. And when we went to the service, of course, his casket was draped in the United States flag. Representative Nielsen, that actually flew over the Capitol, correct?
That's correct, Mr. Speaker. That flew in honor of Danny and his passing. So what we did is it was flown half-mast by order of the governor. And on behalf of all the members of the House, all of us, we would like to present that to Danny's wife, Jeannie, on behalf of all of us here.
Representative Nielsen, if you could come over, let's show over all the members, and then I'll present the condolence resolutions subsequent to that. We will close with a prayer offered by our friend and colleague, Representative Brian Barbin.
Will you please join me in a final prayer to commend to the Lord our God, our great friend and Irish storyteller. Dan was a champion of the working man, an almsgiver, a defender of the powerless and the commonwealth. He did not sit on the sidelines. Lord, let your word comfort all who love Dan, for it is written, let not your heart be troubled. You who believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. Lord, no one understands your justice, your mercy, and your kindness. Grant our brother Dan your justice, your mercy, your kindness, and reward him for his sense of justice, his mercy, and his many kindnesses, all known to you alone. Lord, shield Dan today. Lord, be with Dan. Lord, be before Dan. Lord, be above Dan. Lord, be on Dan's right. Lord, be on Dan's left. Lord, be with Dan when he lies down. Lord, be with Dan when he rises up. We, those who knew his justice, mercy, his loves, and kindness, commend Dan to you and ask for grace on Gene, Mackenzie, and all his family. All of God's children say, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Representative Barbin. Members and guests may be seated. And with that, we will close our memorial service for our beloved colleague, Representative Dan McNeill. The Sergeant at Arms may open the doors to the House.